So we are in the 11th chapter of 7th Canto Srimad Bhagavatam. Today we will be doing 8th verse to 12th verse. If we call ourselves human, then certain qualities are expected from us. Then we can call ourselves human. Or we are no less than an animal. Atato Brahma Jigyasa, that is there. But even to inquire that, qualifications are required. Who can inquire? Only those who have these qualities, they can have this tendency to inquire also. So let us see. If these qualities are there, then he is called as a human. Satyam daya tapa shaucham titikshesha shamodamah ahinsa brahmacharyam cha tyagah swadhyah arjavam. We will take one by one. Let us see the eighth verse. Satyam, he should speak truth without distortion or deviation. You see, our ability principles, they are based on four religious principles: truthfulness, daya, purity, austerity. So here also see, it starts with satyam. Even in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, anuveda karam vakyam, satyam priyam hitam. It should be satyam also, it should be priyam also, it should be hitam also. Not that a cow comes and takes shelter in your house, in your bungalow, or near farm, and a butcher comes behind and he asks, where is the cow? When you say Satyam, here is the cow. No. Satyam, Priyam. It should be Priyam as well as it should be Hitam also. Somebody is dying and you say, what is there? Anyhow, we are all not body, we are just soul. Then that is not the time to speak this. So what is the truth which is pleasing also? At the same time, it should be beneficial also. So Satyam, Daya, one should have sympathy to everyone who is suffering. Then he can be categorized as a human. Somebody is suffering immediately. Paradukhi, dukhi. Rama, he showed how to have this Daya. Whenever somebody was dukhi, immediately Prabhu Ram, he should be dukhi. Prahlad Maharaj, he could not see the suffering of others. He said, I am not bothered, I can stay in hell also. Because in hell I will be chanting the holy name of Lord. I am only bothered for those people who are suffering in this material world. So Daya. So one should have sympathy to the people who are suffering. It's not that you should immediately say, no, because of the karmas they are suffering. That is understood. Because of the karma, everybody is suffering. But then that should not be told in such a way that it sounds very rude. So we should know how to speak. Speech is the most important qualification. And that speech automatically comes what you think. So the thoughts should be very wonderful. If there should be Daya in the heart. If the Daya is not there, if the kathor, very hard-hearted person, then he starts speaking like this. He thinks, okay, because of others' karma they are suffering. No. When somebody is suffering, immediately that the sympathy should be there. Tapaha. One should follow austerities. Like fasting is an austerity. Twice a month in the days of Ekadashi is an austerity. Shaucham. He should be clean. Shaucham. Taking bath at least twice a day, morning and evening, and remembering the holy name of Lord. Shaucham. Then titiksha. Titikshva. Titikshaha means tolerance. So, in any circumstances, inconvenient circumstances, seasonal circumstances, one should know to tolerate. So that is very much important. Because outside things will agitate a person. But if he is tolerant in all the situation, chanting the holy name of Krishna, then he is categorized as a human. The tolerance should be there. Titiksha. Then shamo. Shamo. Here, means control of the mind, not allowing the mind to act whimsically. So, shamaha. One has to control the mind. In mind, so many thoughts come. It is a place where thinking, willing, feeling happens. But one should know how to control his mind. That is known as shama. If he does not know to control the mind, then he is a mad person. Shama means he should know, shamo. Shamo means he should know to control the mind. Damaha. Control the mind, and here damaha means controlling the senses also. If the mind is uncontrolled, then the senses are also uncontrolled. Mind has to be controlled. If mind is uncontrolled, then automatically it reflects on your senses. Then the senses also, they act whimsically. That is why shamaha, damaha, both should be there. All the actions first happen at the level of mind. That is why only a person who chants the holy name, Savai Mana Krishna Padaravindayo, if the mind is always meditating on the wonderful form of Krishna, on the name of Krishna, then that person can easily control his mind. Or in mind, so many thoughts come. Somebody agitates, you feel like to beat him. Or somebody is so wonderful, you feel like to go and say something to him. So in mind, so many thoughts come. Loving thoughts, hateful thoughts. The thoughts in anger. So all these things, so many thoughts come. But one should know how to control his mind. If he controls his mind, automatically the senses will act accordingly. The control of the mind can only happen if one is Krishna conscious. If Krishna is Krishna conscious, then the activities also, which is done by the senses, is Krishna conscious. Ahimsa. Next is Ahimsa. So non-violence. So, ahimsa is at three levels. Ahimsa at the level of senses, Ahimsa at the level of mind, and ahimsa, that is at the level of thought, at the level of thought, at the level of actions, at the level of words. So you feel like to beat somebody, immediately you went and slapped him or killed him, that is at the level of the senses. Then at the level of words, if you speak something ill to somebody and it hurts him, then that is ahimsa only, because you have hurted him, not physically, but by your mind, by your words. Your words were so cruel that it hurt him. And then ahimsa at the level of your thought, though by actions you are not beating him, by words you are not insulting him, but in your thought you have so much cruelty for him, you are thinking bad about him. So that is ahimsa at the level of thought. So these three are ahimsa only. It's not just ahimsa means somebody is killing or somebody is beating, that is ahimsa. Even the words, cruel words, is also ahimsa. The cruel thoughts is also ahimsa. So then brahmacharya. So here all qualifications are given. We are just discussing one qualification. How a person can be categorized as a human. So ahimsa, he should be non-violent. So himsit, himsa, himsa, himsit attitude should not be there. So ahimsa means he should be non-violent. Hinsa at the level of words, hinsa at the level of thought, and hinsa at the level of actions. These three should be avoided. Then it is ahimsa. Ahimsa means non-violence. Then brahmacharya. Not misuse of one's semen, not indulging in sex with women other than one's own wife, not having sex with one's own wife when sex is forbidden, like during the period of menstruation. So brahmacharya, one has to follow this brahmacharyata. One should not indulge in the illicit sex. Then tyaga, giving in charity at least 50% of one's income. Ashishla Prabhupada writes, tyaga, that is given in the shastras also. 50% of the income should be given in charity. But we just give a small thing in charity. But it should be 50%, that is what is given. Then, swadhyaya, reading of transcendental literatures like Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Ramayana, Mahabharata, or for those not in Vedic culture, reading of Bible or Quran. So, swadhyaya. Why it is given for those not in Vedic culture? Because Vedic culture speaks about the spiritual world. Vedic culture speaks about God. Vedic culture is just not speaking about the material world. But Bible and Quran only describe about the material world. How to become a human, but they don't have that much idea about the spiritual world. That is why here, for those who are not in Vedic culture, that is why this clear one line Prabhupada has written. So Bible and Quran can be read so that at least he can come to the human platform. But when he comes to the human platform, then he should actually become, he should think about spirituality. So then one has to read Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, Ramayana, Mahabharata. Then swadhyaya, that is, then next is arjavam, simplicity. Freedom from mental duplicity. Who is a simple person? Who has simple thoughts is a simple person. Simple living, high thinking, whose thoughts are high. But it is not having any duplicity. That means he is not having any diplomacy. He is a simple person, simple thoughts, simple person. High thinking here refers to follows whatever his acharya says. So he is a simple person. He is not something from outside and something from inside. So that is why it is freedom from mental duplicity. So now ninth verse. Let us see what are the qualifications which are given so that he can be a perfect human being. Santoshaha samadruk seva gramyeho paramah shanaihi नृणाम विपर्य ये हेक्षा मौनम आत्म विमर्शनम संतोष ही शुड बी सैटिस्फाइड वट एवर इज अवेलेबल विदाउट मच एंडीवर ही शुड बी सैटिस्फाइड जनरली सैटिस्फैक्शन लाइज इन सीइंग समबडी लेस देन यू इफ यू गो ऑन सीइंग समबडी हु इज हैविंग मोर देन यू यू विल बी नेवर सैटिस्फाइड दैट इज व्हाट इन द चाइल्डहुड ऑल्सो द पेरेंट्स टीच इफ समबडी इज हैविंग 4 or 5 pens and if you have only 1 pen, naturally you will be dissatisfied. Then the father and mother say, see the person who is not having any pen, at least you are having 1 pen. So that is how satisfaction lies in one's own mind. If you don't have to endeavor much, whatever you are having without much effort, then there should be satisfaction in that. If you go on seeing somebody who is having so much and so much because of his own karmas, everybody has according to their karmas. If you go on seeing a person who is having lot of things, then naturally there will be dissatisfaction. But if you really want to accomplish the purpose of a human body, then one should have santosha. One should be santosha. That means satisfied. Samadruk seva. So samadruk seva. That means rendering service to saintly people who make no distinction between one being and another and who see every living people as a person, as a spirit soul. Panditaha samadarshinaha. Samadruk seva. Always be inclined to serve sadhus. Which type of sadhu, which type of saintly people? Who is panditaha samadarshinaha? Who has no distinction between one person or another person? Who sees every living person as a spark, spiritual spark of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Mama mamaivansho jivaloke jivaputa sanatana. So samadruk seva. Then gramya iha upanu maha. Gramya iha upanu maha. Upara maha. He is not interested in gossips. Gramya. Gramya means the local talks or some mundane talks. He is not interested in that. He is not taking part in so-called philanthropic activities. He is not interested. Ramya iha uparama. He is not interested in so-called talks and so-called philanthropic activities also. Like some social activity, social meetings and then get-togethers. He is not interested in all these things. If he has to utilize this human body very perfectly, then these all things one has to follow. Shanaihi, gradually, nunam, in human society, viparyaya iha. So he is not interested in unnecessary activities, nor he is interested in ikshaha, means discussing, maunam, being grave and silent. So he is not interested in discussing any gramya talks, local talks. He is maunam. Maunam refers to he is grave and silent. He doesn't waste his speech. Atmaha. He is grave and silent into himself. That means he knows what is beneficial for one's own advancement. That is how he is like a he thinks about his own benefit also. And what is the benefit of the soul? Chanting the holy name of Krishna. That is why he is not wasting the time in unnecessary talks. Vimarshanam, research as to whether one is body or the soul. So jigyasa is the vimarshanam. He is always thinking about who am I? Am I body or the soul? That means he is trying to research out vimarshanam. Anna adhyaha dehe, a food and drink, etc. Samavibhagaha, equal distribution. Bhutebhya, two different living entities. So he likes to distribute food and some drinks to the people who are needing it. At the same time, he is thinking about the benefit of all living entities. Yatha artaha teshuhu. Then atma devataha buddhihi, accepting as a self or the demigods. Sat, then sutaram, preliminary, nushu, among all the living human beings, o Pandavaha, the ओ पांडवः ओ महाराज युधिष्ठिर श्रवणम दैट इज हियरिंग कीर्तनम सो व्हाट इज बेनिफिशियल फॉर वन्स ओन डेवलपमेंट दैट इज हियरिंग चैंटिंग कीर्तनम च अस्यः ऑफ हिम स्मरणम रिमेंबरिंग हिज वर्ड्स एंड एक्शंस महताम ऑफ ग्रेट सेंटली पीपल्स गते है हु इज अ शेल्टर सेवः सर्विस इज्जः वर्ष्य सो ही इज ऑलवेज थिंकिंग अबाउट serving the great personalities. Ijja, he wants to worship the supreme personality of Godhead. And in this way, he accepts dasyam, the service, sakhyam, to consider as a friend, atma samarpanam, surrendering one's own self, lunam, of all the living human beings. I am this, paraha, the supermost, dharma, religious principle, sarvesham of all, samudrataha, be described fully, trimsa lakshanaha vanu, possessing 30 characteristics, O King, Sarvatmaha, the Supreme Lord, the Super Soul of all, yena by which Tushyati is satisfied. So one who has all these 30 qualities, then Lord is satisfied. So Santoshaha Samadruk Sevaha Gramya Hoparam Shanaihi Nuram Vipariha Yeheksha Maunam Atma Vimarshanam Annadhyadye Samvibhago Bhutebhyashchaha Itharataha तेष्वात्म देवता बुद्धिः सुतरा मृषु पांडवः श्रवणं कीर्तनं चास्य स्मरणं महतां गतेः सेवे ज्यावन तिदार्श्यं सख्यं आत्मसमर्पणं नृणामयं परो धर्मः सर्वेषां समुदाहृतः त्रिंशलक्षणवान् राजन् सर्वात्मा येन तुष्यति ये वन पोजेसेस दिस 30 क्वालिटीज वंडरफुल क्वालिटीज देन लॉर्ड इज प्लीज्ड सो दीज आर द जनरल प्रिंसिपल्स to be followed by all human beings. Truthfulness, mercy, austerity, observing fast on certain days of the month, bathing twice a day, tolerance, discrimination between right and wrong, control of the mind, control of the senses, non-violence, celibacy, charity, reading of the scriptures, simplicity, satisfaction, rendering service to saintly persons, gradually taking leave of unnecessary engagements, observing futility of the unnecessary activities of human society, remaining silent and grave, avoiding unnecessary talk, considering whether one is body or the soul, distributing food equally to all living entities, seeing every soul, especially in the human form, as a part of the Supreme Lord, hearing about the activities and instructions given by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the shelter of the saintly persons, chanting about these qualities and instructions, always remembering these activities and instructions, trying to render service, performing worship, observing obeisances, offering obeisances, becoming a servant, becoming a friend, and surrendering one's own self. O King Yudhishthir, these 30 qualifications must be acquired in the human form of life. Simply by acquiring these qualifications, one can satisfy the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, if we categorize ourselves human, we should see that we have these 30 qualities. Then Lord is satisfied. And when Lord is satisfied, automatically Lord reveals His knowledge. It is not that by our endeavor we can understand Lord. We can endeavor to have these qualities. And that also requires mercy of Lord. And to know Him, if we endeavor for these qualities, then Lord, out of His own mercy, own free will, Lord will reveal His knowledge to us. So in the Purport, Prabhupada writes, human being is distinct from the animals. Because in science we see that human is called as a social animal. Human is a social animal. That is what science speaks about it. But then, if human is only categorizing itself as an animal, then what is the purpose of having a human body? That is why here Narada says that human is distinct from animal. It's not just a social animal. Human being, this body of a human being is a great responsibility. And only in this body we can have the knowledge about the Supreme Personality of Godhead and our relationship with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Only in this human body. That is why human body is a very responsible body and also very fortunate body. So that one can cross this material ocean of birth and death very easily. So in every human being, he should be educated in terms of these 30 qualities. So education should be focused on getting these qualities. We say we are sending our children to the school. Is our school giving this type of knowledge? Is our school teaching how to serve the great saintly people? The school teachings are something like something fictional, like Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. What is the use of a Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall? By which, what are you going to gain some knowledge? At least, if a person is taught, your father is father, mother, guru, they should be treated like God, Acharya Devo Bhava, Matru Devo Bhava, then at least some wonderful things will come. We are not teaching Ramayana, we are not teaching Mahabharata, and we say that we are sending our children to the school. Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya. That is a big proverb which has been put in the school. But what tamas is removed? In the history, if you see, Shahjahan and all those things we are reading. But what is the use of reading all those characters? And then we are seeing that who had been put in the jail, which father put his son in the jail, which brother put his another brother in the jail. What is the use of teaching all these things to the children? Actually, these 30 qualities should be imbibed in our children right from their childhood. If our knowledge or if our teachings are focusing on imbibing these 30 qualities, then that knowledge is perfect. And without the scriptural knowledge, these 30 qualities cannot be put in the child. At least in the madrasa, because here Quran is also given. At least in the madrasa, 30 qualities are at least taught. These all the qualities are also taught, because every scripture speaks about these qualities. Every scripture, let that be Bible or Quran. Because one has to bring a person from an animalistic platform to a human platform. And from human platform to spiritual platform, then you have Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, following the instructions of Krishna, all directly following the instructions of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But to bring a person from animal to the human, one has to take the shelter of the scriptures. So one has to focus on teaching these things in the school. But the school, present day schools, are not teaching all these things. They teach something which is like fictionary, or something which is fiction, or something which is imaginary, or something which has nothing to do with increasing our qualifications. Some stories here and there. So that is has nothing to do with our increasing our qualifications. So nowadays, there is a propaganda everywhere, all over the world, for a secular state. A state which is interested in mundane activities. If the citizens of the state are not educated in the above qualities, how can there be peace? For example, if the total populace is untruthful, how can that state be happy? Therefore, without consideration of one's belonging to a sectarian religion, whether Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Buddhist or any other sect, everyone should be taught to become truthful. Similarly, everyone should be taught to be merciful. Everyone should observe fasting on certain days. Everyone should bath twice a day. Cleanse his teeth, body externally. Clean his mind internally by remembering the holy name of the Lord. The Lord is one, whether one is Hindu, Muslim or Christian. So now, therefore, one should chant the holy name of the Lord regardless of differences in linguistic pronunciation. Also, everyone should be taught to be very careful not to discharge semen unnecessarily. This is very important for all human beings. If semen is not discharged unnecessarily, one becomes extremely strong in memory, determination, activity and the vitality of one's body, bodily energy. Everyone should be taught to be simple in thought and feeling and satisfied in body and mind. These are the general qualifications of a human being. There is no question of a secular state or an ecclesiastical state. Unless one is educated in above mentioned 30 qualities, there cannot be peace. Ultimately, it is recommended. Shravanam kirtanam chasyah smaranam mahatam gatehe sevejyavanatir dasyam sakhyam atma samarpanam. Everyone should become a devotee of the Lord. Because by becoming a devotee of the Lord, one automatically acquires other qualities. Yasyasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarveir gunaistatra samasate sura. रावभक्तस्य कुतो महत्पुणा मनोरथे नासति धावतो बहि. वन हु हैज अनफ्लिंचिंग डिवोशनल सर्विस टू कृष्णा, ऑल द गुड क्वालिटीज ऑफ कृष्णा एंड द डेमी गॉड्स आर कंसिस्टेंटली मैनिफेस्ट. हाउएवर ही हैज नो डिवोशन टू द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड, हैज नो गुड क्वालिफिकेशन बिकॉज ही इज एंगेज्ड बाय मेंटल कंकॉक्शन इन मटेरियल एग्जिस्टेंस विच इज द एक्सटर्नल फीचर ऑफ द लॉर्ड. 5.18.12. Our Krishna conscious movement, therefore, is all embracing. Human civilization should take it very seriously and practice its principles for the peace of the world. So this quotation from Bhagavatam is very important. Yasyasti bhaktir bhagvati akinchana sarvair gunaistatra samasate sura. Whoever has unflinching faith in Krishna, unflinching love for Krishna, automatically possesses all the good qualities of the demigods or Krishna also. He can have even the qualifications of Krishna, qualities of Krishna. So whatever qualities Krishna has, if he has unflinching faith in Krishna, that qualities of Krishna he can also possess. One is trying to acquire these qualities. One is serve Krishna, get these qualities very easily. So that is more easy. But if a person does not know who is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then he has to endeavor to get these qualifications. So whether Bible, whether Quran, or whether any other religious scriptures, they focus on teaching this qualification. So that at least it is not just to particular community. No, for everybody this is common. For everybody, this is one thing. These instructions are common. Like everyone should be clean, everyone should speak truth, everyone should know how to conduct his life. Everyone should serve the mahat sevaya, that is saintly people. So this is a common instruction for everyone. One can endeavor to get these qualifications, and without much endeavor, if a person serves Krishna, automatically he has these qualifications. When he sees somebody suffering, then immediately he has compassion. He cannot see the sufferings of others. He is not cruel by his words. He is not hinsita. He is not violent, neither by his words, nor by his actions, nor by his thought. And the same way, when he sees somebody hungry, immediately he offers some prasadam. So in this way, he distributes the food. So these qualifications automatically come to a person who is rendering devotional service to Krishna. But if he is not rendering devotional service to Krishna, then he has to acquire these qualities by reading the scriptures. So in this way, he has to acquire. One is trying to acquire the qualities. One is automatically he gets these qualities if he serves the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is the power of devotion. The power of devotion is yasyasti bhaktir bhagvati akinchana. Akinchana devotion means unmotivated, undeviated devotional service. If you do this, then sarvair gunaistatra samasate sura. All the wonderful qualities of the demigods. Now, which demigod has been spoken here? Nityasuris. Nityasuri means the assistants of Krishna in the Vaikuntha loka. They are known as Nityasuris. So, he gets all these wonderful qualities of Nityasuris. Harava bhaktasya. If he is abhaktaha, then what is the use of even having wonderful qualification? All the 30 qualification is there. But if he is not a devotee of Lord, what is the use of having all these wonderful qualification? Because he will have the pride of having this qualification and he will try to act what comes in his mind. That is why this Shama and Dama cannot happen. Though he may externally show that I have controlled my mind, I have controlled my senses. Controlling of the body, controlling of the mind and the controlling of the senses can only happen if that mind is absorbed in meditating upon the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. If this is not there, whatever wonderful qualifications he may acquire in this material world, it is all of no use. That is why he will be engaged by mental concoction in the material world. Harav abhaktasya kuto mahatguna manorathena sati dhavato bahi. He is always sitting on the chariot of the mind. Whatever comes in the mind, he will do. That is why even acquiring the wonderful qualifications, but not having this shravanam kirtanam, not having the eagerness to hear about Krishna, to chant Krishna's name, then so-called qualifications are of no use. That is why the last verses which speaks about Shravanam Kirtanam Ijjaha, offering obeisances, worshipping, that is most important. Other all qualifications, speaking truth, taking bath twice a day, not indulging in illicit sex, it's all everything wonderful. But all these has some purpose if there is Shravanam Kirtanam or there is no purpose. Hearing, Kirtanam, Smaranam, so all these things should be there. From the great saintly people, one has to hear. So if these qualifications are there, then one gets the service of the Lord. Dasyam, Sakhyam, Atma Samarpanam. In this way, he understands that he is the eternally the servant of Lord. Then he can also act on the level of friendship with Lord. He can completely surrender to Lord. All these things can be acquired. That is why it is said, Narada Muni tells to Yudhishthir Maharaj, that if a person gets all these wonderful 30 qualifications, then Lord is very much satisfied. So, here we'll stop. Tomorrow onwards we'll see that how Garbhadhan Sanskara, different Sanskaras which has been described in the scriptures, that has to be followed. Because if we have to beget a wonderful civilization, then the Sanskaras has to be done. So all these things, again, because a perfect society is four class social classes. So how a wonderful human race can be begotten? That is all being described from the 13th verse. Hare Krishna.